It is so early right now. It's just after 5 a.m. I am back to my 5 a.m. morning routines. I have not felt better. I'm way more productive. I'm getting so much more done and I just feel overall better about my days and also my body. But a huge thanks to C for partnering with me today on this video. I really wanted to come back and give you guys an update on the DSO1 daily synbiotic. And for those of you who are new here, a synbiotic is basically a pre and a probiotic in one. I'm loving this product so much. I have noticed a huge change in my body overall. And if you didn't know, the gut is truly like the center of the body and really affects how your body feels, right? So we have to take care of it. And I love that Seed has like a capsule, which ensures that the good stuff on the inside makes it to your colon, your gut alive. That way it really works and you're gonna really start noticing changes. Now for me, I struggled with bloating. I struggled with going to the bathroom regularly, you know, for number twos. And I no longer have those issues. I feel so much lighter in my body. And I'm just so grateful. It also helps with your digestive health, your gut barrier integrity, cardiovascular, and also it does have dermatological benefits as well. So yeah, Seed is the first thing that I take in the AM. I also love that they are just so conscious of the environment. So your refills will come in a recyclable package. So you're gonna just reuse your same container from your original shipment. So definitely check them out. The link will be in my description box below. Hey guys, happy Monday. It's about 7:30 right now. I am dressed and ready to go out. I have my coat on and everything because I'm just trying to put my outfit together for the day. But today's gonna be an errand day and I am not excited about it. I have so much stuff to do, like so much stuff. I don't know, it's gonna be a lot. But I'm just getting myself ready. I just did my hair. My hair is growing a lot, as you guys can see. It's giving like the Justin Bieber now and almost touched my eyebrows, which is insane. But I just like to loosen it up a little bit because it is pretty stuck to my head. And although I love that slick down look, today I don't want to give that. I want to just give like very, I woke up like this, easy breezy, model off duty. I'm here because I was made to be here, not because I want to be here. That vibe. So definitely, why did I just do this? Like my hair is not gonna move. But yeah, I just want to like put my hair like that. I'm gonna carry this comb in my bag. I'm carrying my Pullen bag today, this huge one, because again, it's an errand day, a big girl day, lots of stuff to go do. Wait, can I even bring this bag? It seems like everything's gonna be not gonna fit.
I do love these totes. I just feel like they don't have an opening, so I don't really, like they don't have like a proper closing. But honestly, it might just be a tote day. I'm also vlogging on my M50 now because my Canon G7X, I don't know what she got going on, but I'm gonna bring this bag because I just can't be bothered. Just get my belongings together. Okay, so I'm just gonna use it. So I'm gonna use the mini one, which currently has Q-tips. Using the black one for like hair tools. So I have my comb, some BTS clips, some bobby pins, things like that. And this one, so nice. And then in the other one, I'm gonna just put my panty liners. I don't know what pill that is, but I'm gonna put some panty liners in them. It's nice to have panty liners. And I also really like to carry, where is it? I also really like these Honey Pot sensitive wipes. Just kind of keep you feeling fresh throughout the day because I will be outside for a minute. Well, a few hours. This is my Jimmy Choo I Want You travel size perfume, which is actually empty. It's a good thing I opened that. Sanitizer, I don't need to put this in here, but I'm gonna put my Glossier Balm. Got this at the event the other night. This is hand cream. Find travel size powders. I'm gonna just carry this one. It's pretty small as well. I'm gonna carry this Merit lip gloss, and I just need a little brush. But I also might just carry this little sponge. I think this should be good for my makeup bag. It's just nice having something to kind of, you know, touch up throughout the day. So hair stuff and this one. I'm gonna use the Prada refillable thing because it's in like one of those bottles, which makes it easy to kind of put it in travel size bottles. So I'm gonna use this instead. See how easy that is? I love this. Prada included this in their PR package the other day, and I really was very, very fond of it. And you can just turn it to put it to off so it doesn't spill. We are pretty much ready to go. I'm gonna bring this camera. It's a lot larger. Well, not a lot larger, just a bit larger than the Canon G7X, my usual camera. But I figured it'll be all right. I'm just lotion my feet. My feet are so soft right now because I did a little foot mask last night. So I'm just gonna just re-up on the moisturizer. I don't know if these loafers are appropriate for today's temperature. I really don't know. But I'm pretty much Ubering everywhere, so it should be all right. Atalia has been my vibe lately. It's like a very like unique smell. All right, let's head out. Let me call my Uber. Call my Oobs. Alright guys, I stopped at LPQ for a quick latte. The music is so peaceful in here, I hope I don't get copyrighted, but I'm just gonna grab a coffee here, and I grabbed a pastry as well. Then I'm just gonna go to my first appointment, which is at 9. And we have a good like 30 minutes before that, so. Hi guys. All right, so I'm making my way to the first appointment. I underestimated how long of a walk this was. It was probably like 7 blocks one way and then like 4 blocks down the other street. By the way, it's very peaceful in the city because there is no, like it's Washington something, so it is quite slow. Not a lot of people out, so really grateful for that. But yeah, it's really noisy, a lot of construction up this side always, so I'm gonna. So after my appointments, I had 2 back-to-back. It's finally time to have some fun in the city, so I head downtown to Soho. I wanted to check out Zara and see what they had in new for spring, and I did find a few things, but I didn't try them all on because one thing about me, trying on clothes in dressing rooms, I can't. But I grabbed a few things, and now I'm heading over to Staud, a brand that I've been seeing all over my social media that I wanted to come check them out. And the moment I got in here, that green bag, I purchased it immediately. So this is me just trying it on because the color is so stunning. And I love the customer service in this store so much. But I was hungry because I didn't really eat all day. So I got a bowl of chicken noodle soup from Le Pan. And now I'm going to head over to my nail shop. I go to Le Soleil something in Soho, it's on Broadway, just to kind of fix my manicure.
I love manicures now because they're so easy and inexpensive. And now we're at Trader Joe's to pick up some groceries, and then we're just gonna head home. It was so packed in here, and quite frankly, I was over it.
Okay, so I'm back from the city. I stopped into Trader Joe's also before I got home. Let me take this coat off. It is really warm in here. So yeah, I stopped at Trader Joe's before I got home just to grab a few things to have in the house because I've been door dashing. I'm not gonna lie, I've been door dashing. Nothing unhealthy though. I've just been like ordering kava and like little stuff, but I just don't need to do that when I can clearly just cook. Yeah, a little grocery haul. First up, I got this plant. I don't know what this actually, I do know the name of it. It's on it. It's called assorted greens. I don't know what this means. Doesn't smell that great, but yeah, I have this. So I got, this is not baby's breath. It's lavender senesis. I really love the look of like the baby breath, but they smell like literal doo-doo. Into the bags, I have a ton of frozen foods. No shame. All right, so back to what I was saying. I got 2 fettuccine alfredos, and I got some soup dumplings, the pork and ginger one. I got mango cantaloupe. I also got some pumpkin and flaxseed granola. I got some lemonade. I got some peppers. I got some tortilla chips. Thyme. I got 3 yogurts. Spinach. Japanese fried rice because this is so yummy. I got some beef, some salmon, some prosciutto, some chicken. Honestly, none of what I got really made sense. Dishwashing liquid and jam. But yeah, I'm gonna just unpack these things, and I'm gonna cook the beef tonight. Just because I'm in the mood for this. I don't know how I'm gonna make it yet, but I will obviously share with you guys. So I just helped myself to some lunch. I had the pork dumpling thingies. They were okay. As you can see, I didn't really finish them. I don't know. It's like I have like this hunger that I'm feeling, but when I do sit down with food in front of me, like I'm not like eating at all. I woke up so early this morning. I woke up at 4:30 and it's 4 p.m. now, and my body is slowly just crashing. But I do want to get some food in me though, so I'm gonna go cook. I want to make that beef thing I bought. I did buy the wrong cut of beef because I wanted to make like a stew type thing, and I got like, I don't know, I just don't think it's gonna work well for stew. So I'm gonna try to slice it really thin and like sear it up in hopes that it will be like just good to snack on with maybe some veggies. I don't know. As I said, I wasn't sure how I wanted to prepare this yet, so I just decided to kind of do like a little beef, cook up beef, I guess.
So this is the finished product. I just placed the beef on top of the green beans because I'm so hungry, so I'm gonna jump right into eating. For my beverage of the night, I'm having like some blueberry pureed ice cubes with blueberry, like regular water ice cubes. And this is the lemonade from Trader Joe's, but once I mixed them, it turned red because of the blueberry puree like thingy, so yeah. All right, so I'm gonna sip my coffee. I'm going to have breakfast at some point. I would really love to get a workout in, but to be honest, I have a little bit of a headache. I don't know where it's coming from. It could be lack of sleep. It could be lack of water, which is most likely the case. But I would like to spend the day today really hydrating and just taking it easy. It's really gloomy outside, like really gloomy, and I just feel like I don't know how that's gonna affect my video quality for the day, but I'll try filming. Hey Siri, what's the weather today?
The forecast is calling for rain today. Daytime temperatures will hover around 47 degrees, with overnight lows around 38 degrees.
So I'm just going to get started on unboxing my PR now because I would really like to get that done. So, yeah. Strawberry Greek yogurt. I usually don't like yogurt, but it's one of those things that are that's like really good for you. And the only way I'm able to eat it is if I add granola, lots of granola to it. And sometimes fruit, but I don't have any fruit. And I'm gonna be using my pumpkin flaxseed. My mom used to give this to me a lot of times when I was living at home in my teenage years. And I think I liked it. All right, taste test. I've never tried this combo before. Need to load it up with granola because I, oh, okay, let's do it. Okay, it's pretty good. actually no clean area in my apartment right now. Embarrassing, but we're gonna organize today. The apartment's clean, there's just things out over the place. If you haven't guessed, like, this apartment is just way too small for me. I outgrew it the first week I was here, so that's rich. Alright guys, update. It is now 9:06 p.m. at night. I disappeared for a long, long time. After my doctor's appointment, I wasn't really feeling too well because I had to have like blood drawn, which made me lightheaded, and also I got a vaccine. And I don't know, I'm just feeling like very like weird after. So I took a long, long, long nap. And then I woke up and decided to straighten up the apartment because coming into town, he's gonna be here at the apartment with me for like a week or so. As you can imagine, the house gets a little bit lonely without me there, you know? So he's coming up here. So I wanted to like straighten up because I have been spending the past few days just like editing, honestly just being a slob. I'm gonna put it short. Being a slob. So I'm just going to be, so I just basically cleaned up, and then also I had to wash my hair. I had my hair cut yesterday, as I mentioned earlier, and I don't really like when they wash my hair there. I still did allow her to wash it, but I knew it wasn't gonna be like how I wanted it to be. So I got a hair treatment while I was there. They have really good hair treatments there, and I just had her rinse that out and she dried it for me. And then I waited like until today to like wash and set it, but I didn't really do like a wash. I just did a little conditioner and then wet it, rinsed it out, did a leave-in, my Lata body, my mousse, and I just wrapped it and set under the dryer. Honestly, sitting under the dryer, as you can imagine, is just a process that I really dread. So I didn't even care to like vlog it. But yeah, I did clean up the apartment. Hold on, I have the pot on. But yeah, I did clean up the apartment, and right now I'm just wearing my little pajama set from Amazon. I love these. Today's Friday. I am getting ready just for like a really quick little brunch outing, just something really casual. I feel like I've been in the house all week. I've really gone out, so we're gonna go and grab a really quick brunch. I'm thinking of going to like this cafe, which is pretty close by, really good coffee and like really good like pastries and things like that. I really like it. If you're in like the Jersey City, Hoboken area, that's where they're located. There's several locations, but they're all pretty good. I've been to a few. Also took my hair out of the wrap this morning. My makeup bag is in the washroom, so I'm like going back and forth with various products. I'm thinking of getting Botox again, but like under my eyes, I feel like my makeup under my eyes just isn't setting how I wanted it. I usually get Botox in my forehead, which I've like worn out now because I have all this movement again. And I did really like it. I feel like I looked really like fresh with it, but now I'm like, but I don't really need it because I don't have any permanent lines or anything. And I no longer use my forehead as much as I once did. Usually in the past, I would talk like this, like a lot of movements. But since getting Botox and it was frozen for all this time, I just learned to just be a little bit more expressionless. But I'm gonna start using my Dr. Dennis Gross peel. I was on, I think it's Posh Ash Live. I'll link her channel below. And she got PR from them, and she was basically just like unboxing it and speaking about it. And she mentioned that you can also put it under your eyes. And I actually never thought about doing that because the Dr. Dennis Gross peels are so good for just smoothing like your face and like really renewing that whole aspect. Babe, did you notice I went shorter with my hair? Okay, but yeah. Part or no part?
We made it to Pacho. Let's go in. Isn't it so cute? I love this cafe because it is so cozy and like not a lot of people here at all times. And it's very chill. I should come here and work more often, but I don't.
Went to the store in downtown Jersey City called Hannibal & Co. They just sell little random things. So we got this for him. It's like a leather, authentic, genuine leather pouch. Yeah, over time it's gonna age and look like very, very good. So it's incense like sticks. I've never tried incense before, but they smell so good. I got some that smells exactly like, it's called limoncello, but it smells exactly like pine sol. I can't wait to burn it, but especially for my cleaning days, because you know like when you clean and you mop with the pine sol and the fabuloso and stuff, it smells good for like a couple hours and then it goes away. Well, this you can just burn. Did you get, you got a sea salt chocolate, but they have really good stuff in there. This is also the place, it's next door to the place that I purchased my sweatshirts from, the one that has the Chanel and the white, you know, stuff on it. And then finally, we just got a pair of socks. All right, babe, that's yours. I also popped into Cool Vines because I'm such a lover of Cool Vines. It's a young mango soda. So they have really like random drinks in there. Oh my gosh, this camera is so frustrating. Okay. I also got a, I feel like everyone keeps saying how good this water is. It's a Topo Chico. Then I also got this like rosé lemonade. Guys, they have the best little drinks there and I'm excited to try them out. I also got some stuff from the fish market because I really want to make clam and linguine for our dinner. I have my shrimp and I have my clam. And I also picked up two of their seasonings from the store. This is a wok roasted Thai pepper seasoning. A lot of the seasonings in the grocery store, they're just very like salty. So I wanted something a little bit more natural-ish. So I got this one. Today is Saturday and I'm about to get started making breakfast. Today we're having banana fritters. So let's make my banana fritters. I learned this recipe from my grandmother years ago and it's one of those treats that's like so delectable. And I promise you, if you make this for a guy friend, okay, your boo, he's just gonna be obsessed.
Okay, I swear by it, and it works every single time. I'm just joking, but it's just really, really good. So basically, you're gonna take some ripe bananas. I'm using two here with a little bit of vanilla extract, and we're just gonna mush this out. Now, feel free to add some brown sugar if you want it to be extra sweet, but these are like somewhat fattening. They're definitely a comfort food, so definitely don't add any sugar if you're like watching that whole thing. But yeah, we're just gonna mush it out until the bananas become like this like somewhat liquidy consistency. Then we're gonna go in and add a flour. So this is up to you, but the less flour you add, the more the banana fritters are gonna be like on the softer side, which is what I prefer because I don't like when it's too spongy and floury. I like when it has a nice little crunchy exterior and a nice mushy inside. It's just yum. So I'm adding maybe like, I don't know, let's say like 6 tablespoons of flour. And then now I'm gonna fry it. I didn't have actual oil meant for frying, and olive oil is just not the oil for that. You're gonna realize that my fritters were in fact sticking, which was so annoying. But definitely use like avocado oil or like an oil that's appropriate for frying, and you'll have no issues. So yeah, just gonna fry it, and you kind of want these to get a really nice dark golden color. Fry and flip. Keep the heat pretty medium because of the bananas, they do tend to burn really quickly. But because I didn't even have enough oil in this pan and just that whole thing, that wasn't a concern of mine. But if you do have the appropriate, you know, oil and all of that, this will cook pretty quickly. So be sure to flip it and do not walk away from the stove. So let's just watch it and fry it up. Now, the way how I cook mine, as you can see, it's still a bit soft. That's how I like to eat it, but there's some people, they like it to be spongy and doughy, and that's totally fine if that's what you like. But yeah, we're finishing up now. I'm just frying the final 5, and then I like to sprinkle a little sea salt at the end, and that sweet and salty bit is so addicting. And again, this, thank me later. Today's Sunday and I'm in full on cleaning mode. I've decided that I wanted to start cleaning like for an hour every day. That way the mess doesn't pile up like it usually does. So yeah, my machines were going. I was doing laundry, so excuse the voiceover again, but it's Sunday. I did get some more groceries from Whole Foods. I wanted to get some healthy beverages in the house, so we don't have to be like drinking sodas and stuff or juice. So get some like, you know, nicer things in. Some vegetables, peppers, both red and green, carrots, spinach, just some vegetables for this upcoming week. I'm very into salads lately, so I just have ingredients for those things here. But yeah, just a really quick grocery haul. Thank you.
As you saw earlier, I unboxed some, well, did some, I got some groceries. Just wanted to re-up on some things for the week. Now I'm gonna get dinner prepped and started. And I also really wanna make some grape nut ice cream from scratch, but not really, not scratch. I bought the vanilla ice cream and I have the grape nut cereals. I'm just gonna soak them. And I thought I'd share with you guys how to make the ice cream, because I think as a Jamaican living in the US, I think we can agree that grape nut ice cream is so hard to come by, and there are these moments where I like crave it and I go absolutely bananas trying to find it. And it really just, I hate when I'm craving something and I can't eat it because I get frustrated. He did leave today, just like an hour or so ago, to go back to the house. Yeah, it kind of sucks being like in the apartment alone, but yeah, I'm just gonna start cooking now. You know, Sunday tings. I'm just gonna cut up some chicken. I have some chicken thighs. I'm just gonna take out a couple of these ones, the ones that are boneless and skinless. Usually I only buy the, you know, like this one, the boneless, skinless, and everything, which makes cleaning it, you know, extremely easy. But when I eat curry chicken, I just need to have the bone. So these ones take even a longer time to clean. Gonna take the skin off, because I don't cook with the skin. But unfortunately, they don't sell skinless bone in chicken. Cut this part off first. Then I take the bone part and I Those of you guys who don't cook and or don't eat meat, I know you're so disgusted. I know, trust me. But yeah, this is gonna be my meal prep for this week. One thing about me, when I meal prep, I don't like the traditional, like, you know, broccoli and chicken breasts. I want actual meals. Because one thing about me, I'm gonna get tired of this and I don't wanna do that. If I want more, just make more. We are now washing the chicken with vinegar and some lemon. I know you guys are gonna be proud of me for this one. Let's start cutting up our seasonings. I'm gonna keep the bottom on because it will prevent it from burning my eyes. Or maybe it's the other way around. Either way, my eyes are fine. For the curry chicken, I'm gonna use this bowl. I'm just gonna pour my chicken in here, which has been draining. Making my mochi curry. Never used this brand before. I really hope it doesn't alter the flavor too much. But back to what I was saying, always cook your curry. Take a spoon here. Just gonna up Irish potato as well. This is gonna be like a one stew kind of vibe. I'm not gonna like add more water or anything. I'm just gonna add this in as well.
the guancook. Make sure that all the potatoes are fully submerged because they're gonna have to cook down in the sauce as well. Then I'm just gonna add the lid on and it's gonna stay on like medium heat. But let's check on the chicken over here. Making sure that it has a nice little bubble going on. Smells amazing, that I will say. Rice, the water's boiling now. I'm gonna add the rice in. I'm gonna put the foil paper on. I'm gonna seal it with the cover. All right, so grape nut ice cream. All right, so this is the grape nut. It's basically a cereal. If you guys didn't know, grape nut is a cereal. It's been around for many years. The Van Leeuwen, which is a fantastic ice cream brand. If you ever find this ice cream brand at Target, please pick it up and try it. My favorite flavor is their Earl Grey flavored ice cream, but regardless off guys, I mean, just an amazing creamy, yeah, great. And then this is just the Whole Foods brand vanilla bean. I don't know which one I want to use, but I'm gonna like leave these out for right now. Just kind of get to like room, like not melted, but just softer. Anyways, I like a lot of grape nuts, so we're gonna go in for the kill here. Okay, this is your grape nut, and as I said, if you love a crunch in your ice cream, you could just add it as is. But I'm going to add a little bit of hot water here, just so it can like soak, and it's gonna get a little bit softer. But this is my view and what it's looking like. See that? But honestly, just allow it to soak up this extra liquid you see here. And once that's finished, which should probably take like 10, 15 minutes, if that. All right, this is the bowl. We're going to just add the Van Leeuwen. Then we're gonna take the grape nut. I'm just gonna add it in here. I'm just gonna mix it around. Okay. Back into the container. I'm hurrying here because I don't want it to get all like melty. And just because I'm curious, I've actually never tried it just like this before, where I just add the grape nut to the ice cream when it's not soaked. So this is just for experiment purposes only. This ice cream definitely needed another minute to defrost. Urgh, come on. Looks a lot better than the first batch we did, in terms of it's not as messy and like sloppy. But I'm thinking the ice cream is enough to soak the grape nuts. We don't need to add external anything, like water. But also, like, this is a, if you wanted to serve it, you know, immediately, you could. But I like my ice cream like, really soft. I'm actually gonna eat this one. Mmm. Okay, so this is what the chicken looks like once it's been cooked down. You could cook it down a little bit more just for like a thicker gravy, but I think I'm good here. So this is the chicken. And the rice is now finished. I'm sure it's been finished a while ago, but it's just steaming right now. But there's the rice. And I'm very particular with my rice. I like when it's nice and just not too wet. I like when it's like shelly-ish. You see that rice? That perfect texture. That's what I want.
So yeah, I'm just gonna serve up my food now, and I'm gonna eat, become an hungry bud. And then get back to editing. I'm definitely making some headway. I'm nearing the part where I, you know, for today. So that's good. You guys know my plating isn't the best usually. So yeah, so it go. Just gonna eat some rice, not too much. This is the chicken. Make sure you get some carrots in here. Usually I saute some spinach on the side or whatever, but honestly, I have so much editing to do and work that I'm just gonna make this quick. It's a gravy for the rice. This is my, this is my dinner, guys. All right, guys, time to share with you what the ice cream looks like. You're gonna notice in this one, I've already had a couple servings because I couldn't wait, okay? I'm sorry. But what should I share this in? Let's do, okay. I don't really have like a really cute ice cream bowl, so I'm just gonna use this cup. All right, so let me show you what the inside looks like. So this is the first one we made with the grape nut, soaked and warm, and you know, like, you know, soaked. And this is the second one that we had made with the grape nut, just raw, and we just put it in. I do think presentation wise, this one looks way better. And then this one just looks like a bowl of mush. But I love that the grape nut in this one is soft, like it's softer. So it's really up to you and what you prefer. If you do like a little crunch, you're gonna absolutely be obsessed with the one in this container because it is just so good. I'm gonna use a bowl and a bowl because I feel like I want like a really good serving. All right, so this is the first one and it is pretty hard. All right, it's giving grape nut. P.S. I've already tried this several times. It's pretty good. And authenticity of the, okay, so taste, 10 out of 10. Is it giving grape nut like store-bought? 10 out of 10, absolutely. It's giving that, like it's pretty good. Really proud of the presentation, and I think that's going to make me not want to share this bit of the video, but I'm gonna share it anyways. So don't judge the presentation, you guys. It's just one of those things. I don't have a scooper, but if I were to scoop this up nicely, it'll look really, really pretty. But regardless of, it tastes amazing. Try it out, let me know. I'm definitely gonna Google grape nut ice cream picture and put in the thumbnail as instead of this because this isn't giving, but it tastes good, okay?